From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we fight our country's battles in the air, on land and sea. First to fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean, we are proud to claim the title of United States Marine. On November 10th, 1775, a few good men got together, and they were called Marines.
Be it resolved that two battalions of Marines be raised, that they be enlisted and commissioned to serve for and during the present war between Great Britain and the colonies, that they be distinguished by the names of the 1st and 2nd battalions of American Marines.
These were the men called Marines. One whose word you will hear was Captain John W. Thomason. The time was 1918. The place, France. But what John Thomason wrote about his Marine comrades speaks for every man who has worn the uniform from 1775 to today.
There were Northwesterners with straw-colored hair and delicately spoken chaps with the stamp of Eastern universities on them. There were large-boned fellows from Pacific Coast lumber camps and tall, lean Southerners who swore amazingly in gentle, drawling voices. There were husky farmers from the Corn Belt and youngsters who had sprung to arms from the necktie counter. And there were also a number of diverse people who ran curiously to type, with drilled shoulders and a bone-deep sunburn and a tolerant scorn of nearly everything on earth. They were the leathernecks, the old breed of American regular, regarding the service as home. And they transmitted their temper and character and viewpoint to the high-hearted mass which filled the ranks of the Marine Brigade. There is nothing particularly glorious about sweaty fellows going along to fight. Yet they represent a great deal more than individuals mustered into a division. There is also what is behind those men, the old battles, long forgotten, that secured our nation, traditions of things endured and things accomplished, such as regiments hand down forever, and that abstract thing called patriotism, which I have never heard combat soldiers mention. All this passes into the forward zone, to the point of contact, where war is grit with horrors, and common men endure these horrors and overcome them, along with the insistent yearnings of the belly and the reasonable promptings of fear. And in this, I think, is glory.